Test, 1, 2. All right, welcome everyone.
I know your husband's
to our basketball awards night, as well as wrestling awards night. First of all, we'd like to welcome everybody for showing up tonight. We'd also like to take this time to recognize all the hard work and dedication that our seniors, as well as the rest of our athletes, have put in throughout this winter sports season. We're just fortunate that we got to get our winter sports season in with just a few cancellations here or there. Kids put forth a great effort, worked hard. Parents, you did great with your support of our kids as well as our programs, just like you always do. And once again, seniors, like I say it every year, this is another last for you. So for some of you, this is your last awards, other than our end of the year academic awards. But for sports, this is it. For some of you, you still have track, but for some of you, this is it. And we appreciate all the hard work and dedication that you put in. Coaches do, as well as I do, and your leadership that you've brought to our school, and the successful season. Maybe it's not always as successful as we want it to be, but we have our positives that we take away every year, and we will, your seniors, your leadership and stuff will be missed. When we're done tonight, we need all award winners, all team members from both the boys and the girls basketball teams need to come over here, and Danielle's going to take some pictures for the annual. So don't leave right when the night is done. And then parents, if you'd like to take some pictures also, you can do that. I'm going to be the first presenter for the first award because, number one, he is our only wrestler. Cully has been dedicated to the wrestling program of, I call it, the Hitchcock Tuller Redfield Wrestling Program. He's represented us very well over the years. He's put forth a lot of effort, and it's paid off in a couple state tournament appearances. Wrestling is, like we said on a send-off, wrestling is it's an individual sport that you have to have a lot of dedication. I don't know when's going to be the next time we're going to have a wrestler in our school. But he has represented us well. We don't always get a chance to go up and support him. And we can say all we want about he's our only wrestler. But you know what? I've been very proud of our only wrestler that we've had for the past few years. He goes through a lot of meets. He goes through a lot of duels without much support from us, because a lot of times it falls on the same night of a basketball game, and we can't always be there. But the success he's had and the dedication he's put forth over these years, we're very proud to announce that Cully McNeil is our most valuable wrestler. Now I'll turn it over to our girls basketball, and then we'll follow it up with the boys basketball.
Good evening. Welcome to our awards night. I'd like to start with some thank yous. First of all, I'd like to thank all of you parents for all of your support this season, especially you senior parents. You know, we've been through a lot these past 4 years, and I greatly appreciate everything that you all do, and some of you, this is the end of your journey with girls basketball. No, Steve. And some of you get to start all over again with me and keep getting all those emails and messages. And some of you get to wait a few more years or start it now with Coach Noel. But anyways, just thank you all for everything you've done. I like to thank, you know, Coach Solomon. I cannot thank her enough. She seriously is the best assistant coach. She's so knowledgeable. And I appreciate all that you do, and I know I don't say that enough, so thank you so much. And thank you to her family for letting me have her for during basketball season, because I know she's away a lot. And thank you, Coach Noel. They're so easy to work with, and especially with, you know, practicing and figuring out where we're going, you know, things just have gone really smooth, and I appreciate that. You're great to work with. And Mr. Barry, you know, this year I didn't know. If I had a dollar for every time someone said, well, don't be disappointed if you don't have basketball season prior to us starting because of everything going on, I'd be a rich lady. But we did it, and that's a big thanks to Mr. Berry and the fact that we even got to have our conference tournament.
Thank you. shift, another positive, right? Okay. Later, we went down to James Valley, and we had to battle the whole game. Fourth quarter, we were down 10, went on a 14-3 game, three run to win the game, to win, right? Never give up. We went into Regents with a 4-14 record, playing in the same gym that we had the season end the year before, Lake Preston. Down 10 several times, this team found a way to win and advance us on to the next round, getting us our first win in a region game in quite some time, okay? And then we ended up playing the eventual state champion, DeSmet. In that last game of the season, we shot 56% from two-pointers. And I told the boys in the locker room, you just did that against the best team in the state. I already knew they were, okay? Just imagine what we would have done the whole season shooting that against other teams. We wouldn't have been 5-15, we would have been 15-5. And I believe that, boys. We do have quite a bit of fun, and I sure hope that the boys enjoyed the season. It's hard to go a season with less wins than losses. And I give props to every single one of you guys for showing up and working hard. Sometimes I do wonder if the boys would rather play Duck Duck Goose. Hopefully you can tell, I get excited about this team, and I am proud of this team. I truly believe in every single one of you guys, and I believe that we could and would win every game this season. Coach and I look forward to next season and challenge every single player to do the 10,000 shot club, because captainship requires it next year, okay? Not just because of that. We do have to get better shooting. 56% in the last game is great. 18% to start the season is not so good. A few thank yous before I start with the awards. Thank you, Mr. Barry, Mr. Redfield, for always driving the buses to the games. We had a little battle sometimes as to who was going to drive our bus, because Mr. Barry was good luck one time. Mr. Redfield was good luck the next. Maybe next year we'll fight that all a bit more. Thank you to Mr. Barry, Dulcie Whiff, Jake Miller for doing our scorebook for us. Thank you to Mr. Barry again, David Otto and Rod Scorb for always getting the gym ready for us. We always appreciate that. A thank you to our administration for believing in us, Coach and I, to lead these teams. We appreciate that. Thank you to our student managers. This year, Alex and Weston were our student managers, and it was different. We didn't have a whole lot for you to do, right, at times. And then sometimes we had you doing a lot of things, running around and doing everything that we asked. Sometimes getting Coach some food, right? Right? Okay, a couple times. Last one is thank you to you parents for everything that you do, for getting your sons ready. Appreciate the willingness to adjust for practice times, for bus times leaving, or any type of other adjustments we had to make this season, just to help us coaches get these boys ready for the game or practice. Thank you to the fans that show up nearly every game, even the ones that don't even have kids in our school. We see you and we appreciate you. We know that it is easier to sit at home, to watch it on TV, to watch it online, but you can't beat having an in-person crowd cheering for you. Thank you for that. Now on to the awards. We'll do with letters first. We'll get that out of the way because I didn't have that written down. And so if I don't do it now, I will get off track. So first we have Alex Clark. Next we have Cody Wright. Next we have Jack Boomsma. Next, we have Kyle Hamilton. Next, we have Zach Gilbert. There's going to be a continuous one. Jed Waldner. Andy Brooker. Caden Bottom. Kelly at Hartford. TJ Solomon. Carter Binger, who is not here tonight. Cole Schrader. Landon Puffer. Eric Solomon. Jackson Maynard. Alex Whip. And Weston Wagner, who's not here tonight. If you didn't notice, that was all of our varsity players, 15 of them, and the student managers. We had a season where some of the boys got some playing time. Sometimes we were down quite a bit, but we have a group of boys that some of them can play the same as what the varsity starters can play. And that's a great thing to have, but sometimes it is hard to get everyone to play. But it was very nice to have all 15 of you let her. Next thing I had was academic All-State. This year we had one senior that did that, and so his honors is Alex Clark. All right, we'll move on to 281 Conference award winners. This year we had three gentlemen make the all-conference team, starting with Carter Binger, honorable mention. Next we had TJ Solomon, honorable mention. Next we had a gentleman make the third team all-conference, Jack Boomsma. All right, now we'll go on to the scripted awards that I had, so don't get off track here. First award, Cody Wright. We'll get there. You can sit. What can I say about Cody Wright? First of all, Cody, my sons love you and idolize you. I get home from practice or a game, and they would ask about Cody Wright and how he did. Or they would get home from school and say that they saw you and you said hi to them. That goes a long way, Cody, and it means so much to them. My three-year-old, Lincoln, points you out on the TV when they're at home and tells his mother that Cody, that's the guy that talks to me. I think he only knows your name and TJ's, of course, because TJ dunked it, Dad. I thank you for that, Cody. This young man right here loves being a Hitchcock Tudor Patriot. Let me tell you about the conversation I had with Cody the last home game, right over there on the bench during the JV game. He says to me, Coach, I don't think there's a wall, bleacher, or thing in this gym, or in Hitchcock's gym, that I haven't ran into or collided with. I looked at him and I laughed and I told him, you know, Cody, you're right. There probably isn't something that you haven't touched in either gym. Why tell you that story? Well, a couple reasons. First, Cody Wright will run through a brick wall, literally, for this team. His brothers, his coaches, his school. Second, younger players, this is what being a Patriot's all about. Cody Wright will tell you he's not the best basketball player. He's a football player. What I want to tell you, young man, is that for someone who was told early on not to shoot, know your role, which roles are important, don't get me wrong. For someone who could barely walk after practice or a game, looked like he was 80, right? I would tell him to go sit down, take him out of the game, He would walk by me, slap my hand as hard as he possibly could, ice or sit down for 2 seconds and say, "Coach, I'm good. I'm ready to go. I'm good, Coach."
good at right now because when you're moving around, what's your schedule?
Yeah, I was in two weeks.
I said, I'm going to just take the intro. Get it over time?
No, I didn't do that.
That's my goal. I just want to run 100 for Thursday. Because now everything's on the internet. We can play. We can't play. So this, I've already got it.
Just forgot that.